Alright, what's going on guys? My name's Austin, but you can call me FC, and today we are back with another video for you guys, some NBA 2K14, I almost said 15 there with all the new stuff coming out. Not quite there yet, that'll come out in October, I'm really excited for that, but right now we're playing a quick game, and you'll see this dude's actually pretty good, pretty decent, so it's going to be an intense gameplay, so I'm excited to show you guys, but I decided to use the Brooklyn Nets. I used this on a previous series I had, but used this team, but I ended up canceling that, and they're going to use the Indiana Pacers. This is a pretty good matchup, some Eastern Conference battles right here, as they end up kicking out to George, 4-3, in and out, and we get the rebound. So going down the court now, Williams, really beast player, and yeah, you don't lead him open for three as we make it rain, going up 4-3. Now it's 8-7, skipping forward a little bit, still in the first quarter. They end up driving in with Stevenson, but we strip him with the ball and end up going down the court here, looking for this alley-oop, and we lay it up and in. I was kind of hoping for a slam cam, but unfortunately, we only get a nice lay-in and go up 10-7, and hey, I'm fine with that. I don't really care if we get the fancy slams. All I need is the points. That's the thing that sometimes that's what I feel like 2K doesn't understand. They think I want to do some complicated moves when really I just want to make an easy layup and get some points. But they could get out to George Hill, getting a redemption three right there, and we're up 15-13, so still a relatively close game to start out with. And that's one thing I do really hate is blowouts, as Anderson nails the three, and we end up going up by five. But like I was saying, it just seems like even though if you're blowing out a team, it seems like it's more, you know, you're in control, you can kind of relax. I like the adrenaline of having like really close games. It just makes things a lot more fun. But they end up kicking out to George Hill again, 4-3, and nailing it. That was a little bit extra. That was from way downtown, and just like that, we segue into the second quarter, and Paul George with that emphatic slam, that gargantuan dunk. And that's one thing about Paul George, though. I hate playing him because whenever I play him, the guy always does some crazy slam moves, and it kind of gets on my nerves. But they're on the fast break and just nail on the jump shot right here. Well, I said that a little prematurely, but, you know, I knew he was going to hit it. It's not like, you know, Paul George is going to miss an easy jump shot. But we get the nice... Oh, I thought we were going to get the lane with Blatch, but I was just showing you the fails on my team for lousy ball handling and lousy... I don't even know what to call that, just missing a layup, like that's the most simple thing ever. But we're down by 8 here, so my opponent is actually about to blow us out. We're not looking for that though. We kick it out for 3 again, and we miss, but we get the offensive rebound and the slam with Plumlee. That was a nice dunk. It was really fun watching him in college, and seeing him make that transition here in NBA 2K is nice. But we go into the half down 36-32, and you know, it's all good, though. You know, we have a chance. You know, we're only down by 4. That's an easy deficit to overcome. But we're down by 1 here, and they're shooting for 3 and missing. So here we go. We're going on the fast break, trying to take the lead. But we slow things down a little bit. But Livingston with a wide-open path to the basket and the slam. So just like that, we are up by 1. So after going down by 8, we're able to just get some nice lands, you know, not trying to shoot too many 3s. I know we had some 3s early, but we were able to, you know, narrow the deficit, and now, well, now they're actually up by 5, and we hit the 3 to narrow it to 2, so man, this show is just crazy. It's going back and forth, back and forth, but they end up nailing the nice jump shot right there, and a lot of their shots this game have been jump shots, you know, a lot of 3s, a lot of mid-rangers, like that one with West, that was pretty nice, but their team is built like that. I mean, they can kick it out for 3. I mean, with the loss of Danny Granger, you know, they don't have as many, you know, threats anymore, but they do have a lot of nice mid-range shooters, you know, so that definitely has helped them out. But Allen Anderson for 3, and I don't know why, but in the association I had with this team, I actually traded him away, but he's a beast, so I don't know why I left him. But Anderson again for 3, so he's single-handedly bringing this team back. But now we're in the fourth quarter, crunch time, and oh, let's get that steal going down the court. Anderson with the nice lay-in. That was a really bad move on my part. I should have probably passed it. You know, it was really contested. But either way, we're up by 6 here with the time winding down in the fourth quarter. These are the best times in 2K. And even though we're up by 8, oh, that was a really bad pass. I have no clue what I was doing. We tried to throw it back in bounds, but they end up getting the possession and kicking it out To George Hill again for three, and he nails it. Man, he has just killed us this entire game. This is getting ridiculous. And Paul George going in, and he did not do a dunk that time, but still, nice land. He's a beast. I definitely want to get him on my team because I'm just starting that up. But, so they end up getting the rebound here and going down the court. Paul George with a nice land again. Man, he is just doing work. And just like that, we're only up by one with 30 seconds remaining. This is crazy. And we foul them, and that's Kevin Garnett's fourth foul of the game, and so they'll shoot some free throws. He ends up missing the first one, Stevenson. And so if he makes the second one, it'll be a tie game. I'll be perfectly fine with that. And he does miss, so we get the ball back and going inside to Garnett. But we miss! Oh my gosh, Garnett, what happened? How did you miss that? And I just prevent the fast break. I actually didn't know that it was the last foul before it was over the limit. So I did not know he would be shooting free throws. But he does, and he makes the first one. And with 9 seconds, he's going to try to take the lead for his team. And they do. So after all these crazy lead changes, they're in the lead. But Paul Pierce, I wasn't going to take that jump shot. We get the lay-in, though. I knew it would be better just to go in for the layup instead of trying to nail a jump shot in the corner. That usually never works out in our favor. But with 3 seconds left, can they get the win? And no, it rolls in and out. Oh my god, that was a crazy ending to the game. But hopefully you did enjoy, guys. That gameplay was awesome. I love games like that. My heart was racing at the end. And we end up getting the win. So yeah, hope you did enjoy, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.